drums boomed and voices echoed as hundreds of protesters gathered in front of the Vancouver Art Gallery on March 14th. It's a march against the anti-terrorism bill C-51, which was recently introduced by the federal government.
We as citizens of a democracy would fully expect the government to look out for our best interests, to safeguard our rights, to ensure that we have opportunities in order to express our concerns in whatever venue, whatever manner that we see fit. But when we turn and look at Bill C-51, it's extremely troubling for all of us.
The new legislation would increase the powers of the RCMP and Canada's spy agency CSIS in preventive measures against terrorists.
Bullshit.
It's unnecessary. We have enough laws in place now that handle any terrorists.
For some, the bill lowers citizens' sense of security instead of increasing it.
Safety is when you can go into a room and you feel comfortable with your neighbors. And promoting fear isn't how you find comfort with your neighbors and your friends and the people that you meet in certain circles.
Others were concerned about the bill's effects on freedom of expression.
Free speech needs to be maintained so that democracy can run well. And when democracy runs well, that's what prevents terrorism.
A critic says there are more pressing issues for the government to focus on.
More Canadians are killed by lightning strikes, by falling in their bathtub, you know, for instance, and by terrorists. Not to minimize what, you know, the horrors that have happened.
For sure. Yeah.
But if you put it in perspective, an even more significant aspect is, according to the Canadian Medical Association, several thousand Canadians die every year from air pollution. So is the government fighting a war against people who pollute the air? No.
He also says that outside of Canada, there are other ways to improve citizen security.
If we had a positive foreign policy, it's a whole other issue, but say work for Palestinian rights, work for a general peace settlement in the Middle East, getting rid of nuclear weapons in the Middle East, which only Israel has, by the way. If we did that, we'd win a lot of support. And if you're really concerned about the safety of Canadians, if that's your prime function, then I think you would actually make us safer. My guess is the more we get involved and repeat America's mistake in the Middle East, the more Canadians will in fact become a target of terrorism.
For Langara Voice, I'm Vivian Chu.